you, and do not aim at that which is bad to spend from it. Also, Allah mentions in an ayah where He says, وَآتُوا حَقَّهُ يَوْمَ حَصَادِ, where that pay due thereof, like its zakah, according to Allah's orders, on the day of its harvest. When the harvest is ready and you are cutting it is ready, then you pay the due of that. And when we go into the hadith, we find the explanation that the 10th or the 20th part of that. Also, there is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in which he said, "Fima saqat as-samaa'u aw kana 'athariyan al-'ushr wa fima suqiya bin-nadhhi nisfu al-'ushr." On a land irrigated by rainwater or by natural water channels, or if the land is wet due to a nearby water channel, ushr, that is 1/10, is compulsory as zakah on that. And on the land irrigated by well, half of the ushr, and that is 1/20, is compulsory as zakah on that land. This is one of the categories or one of the kinds of wealth on which zakah is required. The other type or kind of wealth on which zakah is required is gold, silver, and money. I'm just going through the things upon which zakah is obligatory. Inshallah, in the second session, we will deal with detail the issues that relate to all these things. Gold, silver, and money. Zakah is obligatory upon that. And if we do not pay zakah, then there is a warning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah At-Tawbah, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةَ وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَهَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. And those who hoard up gold and silver and spend it not in the way of Allah, announce unto them, فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ, announce unto them severe punishment, a painful punishment. Also, there is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the hadith is recorded by Sahih Muslim. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu is the narrator of this hadith. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma min sahibi dhahabin wala fiddatin la yuaddi minha haqqaha illa idha kana yawm al-qiyamati sufihat lahu safaihu min narin fa uhmiya alaiha min nar jahannam fayukwa biha jambuhu wa jabinuhu wa dhahru kullama baradat u'idat lahu fi yawmin kana miqdaruhu 50,000 sana hatta yuqda bayna al-ibad." This is the warning against the people who do not pay zakah of gold, silver. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no possessor of gold and silver who does not pay the due on them, except that on the day of judgment, the gold and silver will be beaten into sheets of fire, which will be further heated in the fire of hell, and then his flanks, his forehead, and his back will be branded with them. Every time they cool down, they will be replaced with heated sheets that will go on for a day, which will last 50,000 years until all the slaves have been judged. So this is something as a warning against those people who do not, who have gold, silver, but they do not pay the zakah of that. One of the kinds of wealth on which zakah is obligatory, is fard, is the business we have, or the things in our business. Goods which are owned to be sold, for example, and this includes real estate, animals, foods, drinks, cars, etc. The owner should calculate their value at the end of the year. For example, when he started his business, then at the end of the first year of the business, and then after every year, and then pay 2.5 of the current value, whatever he has calculated. Also, one of the kinds of wealth on which zakah is obligatory is the livestock. For example, camels, cattle, sheep, goats, on the condition that they are free grazing and they are not fed with grain or specially prepared food, and they are raised for breeding and milking or for milk production. And then there is an isab that, for example, if you have camels, so how many camels, the minimum nisab for that, the cattle and sheep and goats. Inshallah, if you go into the details, you will find. Then the brothers and sisters, most of the times we are confused about to whom we should give zakah. Sometimes we come to the go to the masajid and drop our zakah in donation boxes, and it has been found. Then sometimes zakah was found in, for example, in the donation box. So the brother does not understand who can receive the zakah. Also, sometimes, one time a brother came to me and he offered me two caps, that they were special caps, these kufis, and he told me that this is zakah for you. For example, this is because of misunderstanding or because of not proper understanding of the categories of people to whom the zakah can be paid. When we open the glorious Quran, there is an ayah in Surah At-Tawbah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions 8 categories of those people who can receive the zakah. And the ayah is innama sadaqat lilfuqara'i, that this sadaqat, and here according to mufassirin, the sadaqah is obligatory charity, and that is zakah, is for lilfuqara wal masakin. Number 1, fuqara. Number 2, masakin. Number 3, al-amilina alayha. And number 4, wal-mu'allafati qulubuhum. Number 5, wafir riqabi. And number 6, wal-gharimin. Number 7, wafi sabilillah. And number 8, wabni sabil. And at the end of the ayah, Allah says, faridatan min Allah, wallahu alimun hakim. That this is a farida. This is something which is obligatory upon you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alim and hakim. Faqir, innama sadaqatu lil fuqara. That this sadaqat, the zakah, is for the fuqara. This is the first category to whom you can pay your zakah. Who is faqir? Fuqara is the plural of faqir, and faqir is the poor person. And then people have opinions that what is the difference between faqir and miskin, because miskin also is the person who is poor. So sometimes they make a difference that the faqir is the person who does not beg, who never asks people for money or for anything. He does not have or he does not possess anything or half of his minimum needs or less, and he